Hi, and welcome to this next video on the hardest GCSE problems of all time. In case you're outside the UK, GCSEs are just exams that students in England and Wales do when they're about 16. And these are particularly the hardest ever questions in terms of a very small proportion of students nationally got them right. Now, this question, known as sort of the Hannah's Sweet question, became quite a sort of viral sensation a number of years ago. It was even covered in the media, sort of like, oh, how hard is this question? But it's quite funny because actually, although this question, this type of question hadn't come up for a long time, which kind of bamboozled all the students who hadn't seen a question like this, actually it's relatively routine and has come up since in a number of papers. In fact, there's been much harder questions on this to do with algebraic probability, which is the area. And if you go onto our site, you can find a whole skill on algebraic probability where you can practice. I'm hoping there's a card that's going to appear somewhere around me. I don't know exactly where, so I'm just going to circle my finger and hope it ends up in the right place. So let's tackle this question. There are n sweets in a bag. Six of the sweets are orange, the rest of the sweets are yellow. Hannah takes at random a sweet from the bag, she eats the sweet. Hannah then takes at random another sweet from the bag, she eats the sweet. The probability that Hannah eats two orange sweets is a third. We want to first show that n squared minus n minus 90 equals zero. Now, the first thing to make really clear is that when it says show that, that doesn't mean solve. Now, what a number of students would have done this exam is that they would have just seen this particular equation here and tried to solve it to find the value of n. But, well, that's the second part of the question. That's where you have to find the value of n. So what does it mean to show that? Well, to show that we can get this equation means to use the information from the question, this kind of context here, to somehow come up with, to generate this equation that we've got here. And then the next part of the question, once we've got that equation, is to solve it to find the value of n. So how are we going to use this information here to come up with this equation here? Now, what we'd usually do is to find the a probability like this of eating two orange sweets. It's a sequence of events. And basically, to find the probability of a sequence of events, like one event happening and then another event happening, so eating the first sweet and then eating the second sweet, it's orange, is to multiply those probabilities together. So we're told it's the probability of eating two orange sweets. So what I typically do is what you could draw out a probability tree, but I tend not to if you don't have to. I just write out what the sequence events are. So we're eating two orange sweets. I'm going to say you're eating orange, then orange. I'm just going to use O for orange. I put a colon and then I write out what that probability is. Now, what's the probability that this first sweet that we eat is orange? Well, we're told there's n sweets in the bag and six of the sweets are orange. So if six out of the n sweets are orange, then the probability that the first sweet we randomly choose is orange is just going to be six out of n. If these were numbers, you might think this is a bit easy. If I said there was like, I don't know, 10 sweets in the bag and six were orange, well, the probability of orange is just six out of 10, six over 10. And it's not, it doesn't make any difference just because the number of sweets in the bag is algebraic, it's n rather than an actual number. It's exactly the same principle. So we said it's six orange sweets out of the n sweets in the bag. So I'm going to write that. And then we're going to times that by the probability that this second sweet that we eat is orange. Now let's think about it. We had n sweets in the bag. We've eaten one of them, so we're going to have one less sweet to choose from, because if we ate it, we're not regurgitating the sweet, we're not putting it back. So there's going to be one less sweet. So it's out of n minus one because there's one less sweet to choose from. Now, because also on that first pick we ate an orange sweet, that also means there's one less orange sweet. So there's only five orange sweets left. So out of the n minus one sweets remaining, there's only five left which are orange. So it's going to be five out of n minus one. And as I said, to find the probability of a sequence of events, so the first sweet is orange, and then the second sweet is orange, we're going to multiply these probabilities together. Now we're told in this question, if we look over here, that the probability of eating two orange sweets is a third. So we can set this equal to a third. At this stage, we've done all the kind of probability bit, and we just got to kind of simplify this equation here in the hope that we're going to get this equation here and that we've showed that we can get that equation from the information that's been provided. So let's think how we might simplify this. The first thing to note is that we're multiplying two fractions together. So if I just do this kind of separately for a moment, if I wanted to multiply, say, 2/3 and 3/4, all you do is you just multiply the top numbers together, 2 times 3 is 6, and you multiply the bottom numbers together, so 3 times 4 is 12. And then you can simplify that. So you just multiply the numerators and you multiply the denominators. Let's just rub this out. So let's do that for the algebra we've got here. I'm going to multiply the numerators together. So we've got 6 times 5 is 30. I'm going to multiply the denominators together as well. So we've got n times n minus 1. I'll expand that out in a second. And that's still equal to 1/3. And at this stage, we've got a fraction here equal to a fraction. When you have a fraction equal a fraction and no other terms being added or subtracted or anything like that, then basically we can use something called cross multiplication. And what that means is we can do this times this, this term times this term, equals this term times this term. And you get this kind of cross arrangement. That's why it's called cross multiplication. So we're going to do the 30 times 3, which is 90, is equal to the 1 times the n times n minus 1. So let's just do that. We can expand the second. And then I can just expand that bracket. So we're going to have n times n, which is n squared. And we've got n times minus 1, which is minus n. And we're nearly there now, because can you see in this equation, we've got the n squared, the minus n, etc. We've got 0 on one side. So I'm just going to subtract 90 from both sides. That just gives you 0 here on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, we're doing n squared minus n, and we subtract the 90. And we've got the equation we want. If you want a really fancy way of saying that you've completed a proof, because we've got the equation we want, you can actually put a little square, right aligned square at the end to say that you've proved it. That's another way of writing something called QED. And I'm not going to say the Latin on this video, but that basically means it has been proved. So now we've done part A, which is the hardest part. The second part is we just need to solve this equation to find the value of n. So let's do that. We want to solve n squared minus n minus 90 equals 0. Now, we explore this in detail in other videos, how you factorise quadratic equations like that. So I suggest you view that first. But just to kind of go over it quickly, when you have a quadratic equation like this, and this is quadratic because this term here is squared, if I just put a little 1 on the front here, because minus n means the same as minus 1n, what we do is we find two values that add together to give this term here and multiply to give this last term here. So what numbers multiply, add to give minus 1, for example, and times to give minus 90? So those numbers are, I think, minus 10 and plus 9. So minus 10 and plus 9. So what you do is then you have two brackets, you put the minus 10 and plus 9. So it's n minus 10, n plus 9 equals 0. Now we've got a multiplication of two things. Look, we've got a multiplication of two brackets equals 0. And if the product of two numbers is 0, two numbers times together is 0, then we know that at least one of those numbers is 0. So if the n minus 10 is 0, what minus 10 is 0? Well, it's 10, so n is 10. But if n plus 9 is equal to 0, then n is going to be minus 9. And those are the two solutions. Now, the original question did just say, solve it to find the value of n. It does say the value of n, suggesting there's one. Now, you can't have a negative number of sweets. It says there's n sweets here. It would be quite sad to have a negative number of sweets. So what we do is we reject that solution, just put a cross for it to reject it. So the answer is 10. There were 10 sweets that Hannah had.